Hello and welcome to Power System Analysis 2. We are in Module 2 and this is the Section 6. In this section, continuing from the previous class, we'll be talking about the voltage control at buses using transformers. Previously, we have seen how the voltage is controlled by generators. Now, we'll be seeing the voltage controlled by transformers. Now, it is not only the voltage but also the voltage angle. Now, how the generators were controlling voltage angle? It was controlling the reactive power flow also. The reactive power flow and the real power flow, these changes the voltage magnitude as well as the voltage angle. Now, here transformers can be used to control the voltage. How are these used? There are two different types of transformers. What controls the voltage magnitude and the other controls the voltage angle. So we'll be seeing those type of transformers. So apart from the being a VAR generator, transformer provide a convenient means of controlling the real power and the reactive power flow along the transmission line. So normally transformers are VAR generators. They can provide a mean of controlling the real and reactive power. The real power is controlled by means of shifting the phase of the voltage, and the reactive power is by changing its magnitude. So how the real power is controlled? By changing the phase of the voltage, that is the angle of the voltage, and the reactive power is changing the magnitude. The voltage magnitude can be changed by transformers provided with tap changing under load TCUL gear. So the voltage magnitude is controlled by the transformer using the tap changer, online tap changer, and the voltage is directly proportional to the reactive power, so it can control the reactive power here. The transformer specifically designed to adjust the voltage magnitude or the phase angle small values are called regulating transformers. So these transformers are specifically used to regulate the voltage, and it is called a regulating transformer. Please note. Now let us see the control of the voltage. So you have a regulating transformer for the control of the voltage magnitude. So nothing but you have this online tap changers. You have this three-phase transformer connected to a three-phase line, and you have this online tap changer that controls the voltage output. A regulating transformer for control of voltage magnitude, which is achieved by adding in-phase boosting voltage in the line. So it adds a boosting voltage in the line. So you can see it adds a boosting voltage by again using a transformer, and the voltage is obtained from the tap changer from the control transformer. Okay. Now, when we are talking about the regulating transformer, previously we have seen that the voltage control, the voltage magnitude control. Now we'll see the voltage angle control. A regulating transformer which shifts the voltage phase angle is with no appreciable change in its magnitude. So it can also, the regulating transformer can change the voltage phase angle. This is achieved by adding voltage in series with the line at a 90 degree phase angle. So you can see there is here the voltage is added in series with the line. Okay. Now, not only the magnitude is added, it is also added with a phase difference of 90 degrees to the corresponding line to neutral voltage. So that can be seen by this phasor diagram. So on the right hand side, you can see the regulating transformer of voltage control. Okay, so it is a delta shape transformer which have a tap changer to change the voltage phase angle. Okay, so here is the phasor of the voltage transformer. Okay, so if you see the phasor, the amount of tap changes, the tap changes will increase the voltage by a small t. So what we have, a voltage AN now is shifted by an angle of voltage AN dashed, sorry, V dashed AN, and this V dash AN is nothing but VAN plus TBC. It is nothing but the voltage that is added due to the tap changer on the B side or the BC arm. Okay, so it is the volt, the VAN, the newer VAN or the voltage of the A side with respect to neutral is now shifted by an angle of variable alpha. Alpha is given by 1 tan inverse of root 3 T. Okay, now T is, what is the T? T is the amount of tap changing. Okay, now for furthermore discussion on the tap changing transformer, the presence of regulating transformers in line modifies the Ybus matrix and thereby modifying the load flow solution. Now when we have this modifying voltage control transformers, it hampers the load flow equation as well. That means that load flow equation, something has to be changed because a newer transformer is being added which actually changes the voltage magnitude and the angle. So let us understand how this is done. Consider a line connecting two buses having a regulating transformer with off nominal turns, that is tap ratio alpha, including at one end as shown in figure 6.18. So this is the figure that is been seen. We have a bus 1 and a bus 2 connected by a line, and in that, in between that, we have this regulating transformer. Now when you see the circuit diagram, can be represented something like this. So you have bus 1 with a voltage V1, with a current I1 is flowing, with a apparent power of S1 flowing from V1 to V2. Okay, we have this changing regulating transformer here, and it is connected to the line connected to V2, and V2 also is injecting an apparent power of S2. Okay, so it is quite accurate to neglect the small impedance of the regulating transformer, that is, it is regarded as an ideal device. So if we neglect the impedance of the regulating transformer, our equation modeling would be easy. So in the figure 6.18b, that is nothing but the schematic, the circuit diagram which we have shown here. Okay, give the corresponding circuit diagram representation with the line represented by a series admittance. Now since the, now you look at for the calculation, since the transformer is assumed to be ideal, the complex power output from it equals to the complex power input. So S1, it is nothing but V1 I1 star, that is alpha V1 plus I1 dash star. So it is, what is I1 dashed? I1 dashed is the current that is coming after the regulating transformer. Okay, since it is the apparent power in the transformer, there is no loss of the apparent power, it is just transfer one power to the other. So before the regulating transformer, it is the apparent power is SI. Okay, and after that you will get alpha V1 I1 star. Okay, now for this transmission line, what is this? So I1 dash is nothing but Y. Y is the admittance of the transmission line into alpha V1 minus alpha V2. So within the transmission line, we have it is connected to alpha V1 to alpha V2. And I1 is nothing but alpha star I1 dash, that is alpha square modulus of alpha square YV1 plus alpha star YV2. Okay, and the I2 is given by YV2 minus alpha V1. Okay, so the new matrix can be represented, the Y matrix can be represented in form of the matrix of alpha square Y minus alpha star Y and minus alpha Y and Y. So this matrix is now included in the Y bus matrix. Okay, so this is what it is being shown, that when there is a regulating transformer with a regulation with a tap changer of alpha, the value of the Y bus matrix will be changing, and you have to include this matrix in the lower in the Y bus, and then we have to calculate the load flow. Okay, so this is how the regulating transformer is included in the load flow. So this is the end of the lecture. Thank you.